Tonight we have a very special game of Dungeons & Dragons to present, where our party will have to survive a haunted mansion. Tonight we're joined by none other than Holly Morenstein, and he is going to be playing one of these groups of innocent teens trying to lose their virginity at a party after homecoming.
Thank you. Thank you for inviting me to lose my virginity this evening.
This campaign is going to be a little funnier than the others because all the characters are going to have to be playing as medieval teen high schoolers, all part of different cliques, all with their different personality types. It's going to be a little less serious than some of the other campaigns, but still going to have all the great D&D action that we know and love. Homecoming just happened. Was it a success? Was it a failure? We'll find out. But nonetheless, there's an after party happening at your friend's dad's house. His parents are out of town, so that means the whole house is yours for partying. You've all had this conversation before, and you're about to have it again. Tonight's the night you guys have to lose your virginity. You've been talking about it all year. It's your senior year, last year in high school, and you somehow didn't lose your virginity yet, and you've decided this is the place to do it. This is the perfect place, perfect time. The whole house is yourself. Tons of girls are coming over.
So this is a weird situation because we're all kind of like from different cliques in the high school, but we're all pretty good friends.
We were all friends like in grade school. Yeah. We met kind of like separate ways in high school, but we were all tight from.
Yeah, we were all nerds in middle school.
I mean, I don't know if I really considered you guys friends back then.
Okay.
But I did spend most of my time with you.
Right. We're all level one humans.
No, I'm a gnome.
God damn it, Nico.
So every point to your character is just for one.
All right, quick. So this is my character. His name is Drago. He's a super edgy goth kid in high school. He's kind of the leader of the goths. He tells everyone that he's half vampire.
I'm a vampire. Duh.
That was my next guess.
But secretly, his father's only half vampire, so he's really only a quarter vampire. So a lot of times he like uses that as an excuse to why he like can't do sports or like doesn't want to go outside or wants to miss a test. But if his goth troop ever found out, he would never be able to live down.
Do you have any completely intense flaws or anything?
My intense flaw is the fact that my weak spot is that I don't ever want people to know that I'm not actually half vampire. So I fake having like sun sickness and shit. I don't actually have any of their weaknesses or their benefits, but I like to pretend like I do.
Okay, got it.
Like when the sun comes in, like, oh, guys. Yeah, I'm like, you know how
I gotta get inside, guys.
I can't come into school today, it's too sunny.
Exactly. That's my main problem. Yeah, but I literally have no bonuses or weaknesses from the vampirism.
Okay.
Family.
Cool. Harley, how about yourself?
Like, you might be a liar even. Your dad might be lying.
He probably is lying. Yeah, he's not even half.
What's your character's name again?
My character's name is Drago. I am a rogue.
Drago. Cool. Harley.
My character is Frederick Dubray, a.k.a. the Earl of Misty Meadows Castle, the dirty castle over the bridge. No one ever goes there because my father, Duke Tybalt Dubray, is just like disgusting. He was kind of banished. No one really trusts him, but whatever, you know. Turned me into the rebel of high school. I mean, I don't even care about anything. Don't care about friends. Don't care about grades. Don't care about obligations or responsibilities. Sure as hell don't care about the goth gang or who's the coolest of them. But, you know, that's just on the exterior. Deep down, I really want my father's approval.
Oh, Dad, what about you?
Fuck you! No, Dad, what about you?
And I know I would never get it. And I didn't even graduate. I think I'm the only one of the gang that didn't graduate. I'm not even invited to homecoming. I just, you know, I know you guys, I know it's gonna be a party. I heard people are gonna be losing their virginity. I lost my virginity like 10 times already, I bet. Like, I know how to sex the most. I'm cool like that. I'm crashing. I carry my granddaddy's switch-activated elven dagger. It's legal to carry. That's mostly why I carry it. I also carry an ounce of halfling leaf, which I like to smoke. Mm-hmm. And sometimes, you know, I sell it on the side. It's not like that's, you know, the end game for me. I'm obviously gonna get a better job in the future. Just for now, it gives me money, you know.
You're
what
eventually
I mean?
You're gonna not work at the movie theater.
Yeah. strength, intimidation, terrible charisma. He's untrustworthy. People that meet him are like, the eldest son of Tybalt Dubray. We heard he fucks sheep. Are you like that too? His son, probably. He's a liar, he would lie about that. and he's not that smart. He never graduated. And yeah, that's I guess that's his biggest flaw is he comes into every single thing carrying the family, like just
the shame.
The shame.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's rough.
Yeah. They say his daddy fucked sheep. Might not be true though. Who knows what it is? There's millions of rumors. I actually don't even know. My dad doesn't talk to me. I don't care though. Forget him. There he is, Frederick Dubray.
Oh wow.
You can call me Ricky D though.
Ricky D?
Yeah.
All right. That's incredible. Brandon.
My name is Wolfgang, and so only these three guys, because we are childhood friends, know this, and I've kept this secret from the whole school. But I'm half man and half werewolf, and the way that works out is waist up totally man, waist down totally werewolf. So I've always worn long pants, socks, everything. I've hid it from everyone at school, no one knows, and because of that, I'm real shy about the ladies because I know they're gonna be startled when this comes out.
Why? Women are comfortable with lipstick.
Yeah. Yeah, it's full red rocket down here. But
that has to be your nickname.
Red Rocket.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's your name on the track, right?
The name of the track. So I'm on the high school track team. I'm easily the fastest guy in the
track
whole
star.
In the whole fiefdom or whatever we are here. Great sense of smell, very alert, ears, you know, all good. So the charisma's a little low because deep down it's that. But fortunately, I've managed to acquire a bag of five magic beans that will if anyone wants to take them with me tonight, I'm hoping some girls are looking to get a little experimental. It polymorphs you into an anthropomorphic animal of a familiar size. And so I figure that might be able to be my cover for my disability.
So if I took one, is each pill associated to a specific animal, or you get to be like, with the powers of this pill, I choose a bird?
It's a mystery bag.
Yeah,
it's mystery bag. Something.
Random.
But mass is conserved, and so if you
so
weigh,
I could be a 200. Well, Ricky D could be a 185-pound gerbil.
Yes,
if that was okay.
Yeah. So he always has, and you'll walk on two legs, no matter what. So it's like an anthropomorphic gerbil that's that size. So it'll be. I don't know. It could be any mythical or non-mythical creature. It could be.
It's but a pretty high level.
I have goosebumps thinking at the results.
It doesn't really matter what animal it's going to be because he's just trying to do it so people feel comfortable.
If I take one or pretend to take one, either way, it doesn't matter because, you know, I've got that's my cover. Okay. You guys, I trust you guys won't out me in this plan.
Yeah.
And it's going to smooth things over. A little bit of people like to get experimental at homecoming after.
Drago.
Yes.
What are you bringing to the party? What's your thing? He's got elven or gnomish leaf. Elven leaf. You've got these magic beans. What are you gonna bring to the party to make it really good?
It's actually I just put halfling weed, but I want it to be his people's leaf.
Gnome leaf.
Yeah.
All right.
I'm bringing a vinyl of I'm like really into underground music, and by underground I mean like dwarven metal, like literally played underground in caverns.
We're just like banging pots and pans and stuff.
Yeah, yeah. So I'm bringing my custom mix tape. It's on a vinyl printed out, you know.
Wow, it's like you have to find like an old steampunk record player.
Yeah, that's a fine one, but this house looks big. They probably got
it. It's literally like a sheet with like holes in it that like goes through a crank and you turn it.
It's a paper.
Yeah, that's how they do it underground. That's like the new way of doing it.
My character, by the way, right here is this guy here.
This amazing hero.
Gerard.
Wow.
It's amazing here.
Looking
never. I would never know he has a dog neck.
No, I cover it well.
All right,
cover it well.
Nice armor.
Beautiful. Nico.
All right. So my character's name is Nedrim.
Nedrim.
Also basically the IT guy at our high school, the guy who's into like all the like.
They let you
basic
run all
physics.
The IT.
No, I'm just his like teacher's pet. I'm really into like how the school runs and all that kind of stuff. Basically.
Real quick, what kind of medieval IT is going on?
All about like the pyrotechnics, the sound system, the lights. I've actually devoted some of my like wizard training into like trying to do like cool like lighting setups because deep down inside I really wanted to become a DJ. Like I really want like this party I'm bringing my whole sound
system.
You're
doing that because you want to be a DJ?
Yeah, like my dream is like someday
he's
basically
a home
like
DJ. He's like an aspiring DJ.
Yeah, I want to be like hosting like massive like medieval ragers and like be that guy up front like just hyping up the crowd, you know? But like I know nothing about music. I only know how to basically set up sound systems and light shows.
So what are you bringing to the party? What are you going to bring to make this special?
I'm bringing the sound system.
What's that?
It's basically a fancy music box. It can play the underground.
You're bringing a music box.
And like amplifiers.
And like big cones?
Yep.
A music box and cones.
Well, the tinkering thing is, that could be interesting, is every music box maybe requires someone to operate it except for his. Well,
I have a spells up my sleeve to like really put on a nice show here.
Dang.
I don't actually need anybody to crank the music box anymore.
That's sick. I mean, I actually don't even care about spells. I feel like they're stupid.
I'll tell you right now, the music box definitely needs to have a crank. So we have a goth.
We got a goth, we got a bully.
I'm the rebel. The rebel.
We have a rebel. Homeschool.
Not a bully. He's not a bully.
Rebel.
Okay.
Although he's a dickhead, he doesn't set out to make people feel worse about themselves unless he himself is, I'm perfectly describing, a bully. Yep, he's a bully. he's the rebel, though. Class rebel.
Okay, cool. Dude. And then we got a jock.
Jock with a secret.
Yep. Jock with a secret. Don't all jocks have secrets. And then we got a nerd.
Yeah.
With that being said, the game begins. You guys walk up to the house and see Chad.
Yes.
He's standing there and he's like, dudes, what took you so long, man? I've been waiting here for like 2 hours.
Yeah, you know, it's actually not that easy coming all the way from Misty Meadows, Chad.
Well, guys, like the place is totally empty and I'm just waiting to get this party on. I heard girls were coming. Did you guys invite any girls?
We thought the girls would be here.
I thought you invited all the girls.
I mean, I asked like one or two, but I didn't think anyone would come. I thought you guys would ask some girls.
If you would have just told me to invite all the girls, I would have invited them, but I just thought
I would have invited all the two I know.
I actually like have lots of girls that no one ever met because they don't go to our school, but I do have like a whole, now it's too late, I can't, but if you told me, I probably could have filled the whole house out. Yeah, but I don't know if you'd want it. I mostly already lost my virginity to all of them, so.
Yep. Well, you know, that's, god dang. Well, you know, maybe we should just go chill inside. Maybe someone will show up at some point. Here, let's just go inside.
See? How happy are you now?
Chad walks up to the front door and he starts jimmying with his key and he turns it. It seems like it's a pretty heavy door. And it swings open with a really, really rusty creak. Let's go, I'm going in.
All right, sweet.
All right.
By the way, no girls are coming, does anyone want to buy a gnome leaf off me? It's going to be a pretty shitty night. Unless you do.
I was hoping you were going to pass that around.
Yeah.
I mean, okay, Trackstar, like, I'm going to pass it around to you anyways. All right. Listen, just let that marinate. Don't even make a decision now.
All right.
But as the party goes on, just think about it. Your boy, I got the gnome leaf.
It might be one of those nights.
Are you guys inside yet?
Yeah, well, I'll move inside. Let's do it.
Yeah.
This house looks real nice. I've been to Chad's before. It's a pretty chill place.
Right as everyone gets inside, you hear a voice from down the bottom of the stairs.
Oh,
he's like,
hello? Hello?
I go to the door.
Dude.
This girl's going up.
Hello? Hello? Oh man. Is anyone here? Hello?
Hello? Hello?
Dude, I'm gonna head right back to the door and like, Dude, Nedrim makes a move, man. He goes right up to the door.
Nedrim goes right up to the door. and this girl like is looking at like, hello? I heard some people were coming here tonight to maybe, it's a party or something?
It's just getting started. Come on in. Let's.
Oh, perfect.
Dude, just about to crack open some barley wine.
It was so quiet outside. I didn't think anyone was here.
Oh, I just haven't set up my box and cones yet.
Like, I come over. I go, hey, let me do a perception roll. How hot is she?
Wait, hold on. I have an excellent joke that my character would say. Hey, there's a girl here. Looks like we don't need your box and cones anymore. They're walking through the front door. Whoa.
Oh, Ricky D.
Classic Ricky.
All right.
I'm going to do a perception check, see how hot this chick is. Hold on. Boom, that's a fatty perception check. 19 perception.
That's a smash. Jeez.
That's a smash hit.
She's very, very attractive.
Very. Give me one to hundo.
One to hundo? She's like an 88.
Woo! 88's my favorite number, son.
She looks like she goes to your school, but you don't really remember her name.
We have a lot of people at that school?
Yeah, there's like 100.
Okay. I'm gonna ask her what her name is.
Yeah.
Dude, Nedrim's like, hey, what's your name?
It's like, oh, hey, my name's Faye. You're Nedrim, right? I think I saw you fixing something once.
Yeah, that's me.
As he giggles.
Because you're the only gnome in the school.
Yep,
it's hard to forget.
Yeah, that's me. All
right.
Yeah, cool.
Oh wow, that's cool. Hey, are any of my friends here yet?
I like that you were getting bashful, even flirting with the role playing. I mean, you're like, yeah, that's me. I don't know about fixing it.
Shucks. She walks inside.
I'm gonna walk up and I'm gonna put my arm up, put my hand like lean on Nedra's shoulder. I'm gonna walk up,
closing target acquired.
Introduce myself as Wolfgang. Wolfgang.
Wolfgang.
Wolfgang.
Wolfgang.
Wolfgang. Wolfgang. And just reach out and shake her.
He's
hand.
Like, oh hello, Wolfgang. He's like. You won the homecoming game. Wow, you ran so much faster than everyone else. That was incredible. Wow, good job.
Barely broke a sweat.
That's incredible. You must have some real intense, real strong legs.
Oh yeah, I've been training every day of my life for running.
Oh wow. So if anyone wants to make like rolls to like try and deduce who she is, a little more about her, etc.
Yeah, I'm gonna see what kind of clue she's running with. Because right, like,
oh, I'm gonna put a hold on you for a second. Because
right. Like she's hot and all, but if she's like not cool enough, I can't be seen with her. All
right.
My friends will think less of me. I got a really bad roll. I was like 7.
She looks like kind of she's like an art student.
Okay, so she's like an artsy type.
Yeah, but a little more like. We're talking like vegetarian, kind of artsy, like.
Are we talking like wears glasses and ponytail, but you know if she took them off, like let her hair down, she'd be like real
She
hot.
Went out, she hung out with wood elves once and will not stop talking about
oh,
it.
Oh, bro.
So.
God, okay. I asked her, hey, you mentioned some friends. Do you get a lot of friends coming?
Yeah, my friend Gertrude said she's gonna show up tonight.
Man, she sounds hot.
She's like, yeah, she said she was showing up. I don't know who else is though. Chad says, hey guys, can I talk to you for a second? Is it cool? You guys want to just come over here real quick?
Hey, like all of us. Sure. We need to have Faye.
We need
all
yeah,
of
us? Except yeah,
for,
yeah.
Except for Faye.
Just because between you yeah. and me, all right? Just between you guys and me, all right?
Good. Sure. Yeah. Just hang out just a second. We gotta talk to Chad.
Hey guys, all right. So here's the deal. You know, because you guys were saying how you want to lose your virginity and all. And I do too, real bad, but.
Where is this going, Chad?
I was just gonna say, I think tonight we should sign a pact that no one gets to leave this house until they lose their virginity, just so that way we all work extra hard to try and do it.
I just wanna say, personally, I hate my house, sucks. Misty Meadows is a long walk. I was gonna crash here anyways. And I mean, I already lost my virginity a bunch of times today, so I'm cool staying here.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
I'm
pretty confident that we'll be able to do
is
it.
Is it a blood pack?
Yeah, with the blood and a knife and a scroll. It's good. It's real
the blood
serious.
Scroll pact.
The blood scroll pact. It's really serious.
So it's like John Wick 2.
Question.
It's
John Wick 2.
Guys, I don't think we should do a blood scroll pact. That's
that's pretty intense.
My mom warned me about
this. You know what? My dad does blood scroll packs all the time, and they're like way chill.
Yeah. I was going to say too, like I don't believe in making a pact unless there's going to be blood on it. What are we gonna do? Promise each other, pinky
just,
swear.
Just promise to me, guys. You guys won't like bleed too much, or I might get too excited.
Listen, dude. obviously, the gnome doesn't think he's gonna get laid tonight.
Oh, you're
so
right. That's
what it is.
Look, guys, I want to fit in, so I'll join you guys here.
You know, Nedrim, this is a big house. If you lived in this house forever, it might be okay because it's real nice.
You're right, actually. I can crash.
It's like, a big house.
Chad, is it cool if I crash here for a while if it doesn't work out tonight?
Yeah, totally. We got extra rooms and stuff all over here. We can sleep everyone here. Don't worry.
And there's more girls coming, right? I mean,
yeah. Well, what did she? Faye said she had a friend coming or something. I totally invited 2 other girls too, so that probably means that there's enough for all of us.
Sam makes uncomfortable.
We'll figure it out, right?
Well, Chad, if you don't get laid, it's cool because you live here, right?
I live here. I don't have to leave.
Yeah.
Shit.
That's a great point. Yeah. Oh. Question. You said a blood pack, a knife, a blood, and a scroll?
Yeah, I got the scroll right here. You just gotta write your character's name on it.
Okay.
Your blood.
Do you have any other scrolls, by the way? Because I brought all this gnome leaf.
Mm,
and a couple scrolls would be good for me if I got
I think my dad's got some scrolls in his office. We can pick those up in a second.
Cool. Yeah, I'd love to sign this right.
I just blood stamp it here.
Yeah, just like blood that. Stamp it.
Okay.
Yo, Ricky D, I'm cool. I have some scrolls.
Oh, you got scrolls?
Yeah, he wants some scrolls.
Cool. Do I have a pipe? I got my pipe. I'm cool. Just saying, sometimes the ritual of smoking gnome leaf with a scroll is far superior to just banging it out on a pipe.
Especially at a party when you got to pass it around.
Exactly.
Yeah, you need to tell me, like, I know all about that, being a gnome and everything.
Yeah.
I totally like get what you're saying.
That's right.
Okay, I'm gonna sign this real quick. Cut my finger there. Try and slam some blood right in there, no problem. And I'm gonna head right back over to Faye.
How much HP do I lose for cutting my thumb?
Zero, don't worry. It's all good. Just constitution save, and if you fail, you instantly die.
Yeah, I want to be the first stopper.
Instantly die.
Did Drago sign it?
No, I haven't.
Drago, in vampire country, blood scroll packs are like conversation starters. You're like, it's just constantly doing. All right, cool.
Aren't all vampires supposed to be like good at math or something? Isn't that how it works?
Well, we've been fly for long enough to, I guess, do algebra 2.
Is it true that all
vampires can read? Everyone signed it.
Can read?
Yeah, isn't it true that all vampires can read?
All right, so,
We can't read?
Well, I don't know. Did you learn how to read?
I learned everything I needed to learn in the first grade, that's why I
Chad left. Rolls the scroll up.
I mean, I learned how to read.
Chad's rolling the scroll up. He's like, all right, dudes, this is the night we were born for. We were living for all up until today, so let's make this shit happen, all right? You guys want to get fucked up now? You want to get some drinks and shit?
And I hit play on the music box right there.
Where did you put the music box?
It's in this room. It's like in this corner, actually.
You guys signed the blood pact. Cool. Chad rolls the scroll up. He's like, all right, guys, let's do this. Y'all want some drinks?
Yeah!
And so you turned on the music box. The tunes are playing. So, by the way, that's cool. You can hit, what kind of music is it?
Dwarf step.
Dwarf step?
Yeah.
No. I go, wait, you got to take that. Can't have that.
No, we'll switch. I'm just getting the mood going.
Yeah, it's going.
It Ladies is. It's a faux pas. Like, we can't tell the DJ to play what we want. You know, I don't think he takes requests, you know? But he is a gnome. You can convince him just kind of, roll up on him.
And you hear you hear a knock on the door.
Well, she's not cool enough.
Shotgun, this one's mine.
You hear a knock on the
door. Oh, that was a loud knock. I don't want it. Let me see.
Big hand. I don't want
it.
All right.
Okay, I'm going.
Sorry, I couldn't hear the music. Excuse me. Oh, you're answering.
Yeah, I said I ran to the door.
All right, so.
But I go to the door, but I'm like, I don't even care, by the way.
Okay.
I don't even care who it is.
Like, sure.
Just, maybe right. I thought you guys.
So you open, yeah, you open the door.
Yeah.
And behind it is a girl.
The prettiest girl he's ever seen.
Yeah.
And that music plays and like in all those movies. As he stares at her and
and she like looks up and she sees you and kind of like smiles.
And I'm like, I don't care.
And she's like,
is this the party?
And she's,
oh
no.
I look over a guy, oh my God, that has to be Gertrude. Oh man.
Yeah, let's get this shit started. She busts right in, like, it's like,
oh, is this dwarf step?
I want everyone to know, I'm still down. Totally still down. Listen, I know what it's like to be judged early on things, so I don't hold it against anyone. I mean, she might have a voice as rough as the rockiest roads, but she still might have a... as sweet as the most beautiful flower. So I'm into it.
All right. So I'm gonna walk up to Faye and tell her we're getting some drinks and see if she wants one.
She's like, yeah, sure. Okay. I'm down. I could use one. Chad opens up the door and walks into the dining hall. Sick. And he's like, hey guys, who wants a drink? I'm going to get one.
I go, Chad, could you give me a glass of red wine, please?
Oh yeah.
I think we should all just go.
I think it'll fit my aesthetic.
Faye's like,
perfectly.
Oh, give me a glass too. He's like,
Yeah, glass for me.
Gertrude's like, oh, I'll come with you.
Here we go.
Let's get the night started. Chad goes down over there. Paige follows.
I'm going with two.
Because Gertrude was so quick to follow Chad, and my insecurities would never allow me to live down being cucked. By Chad, I kind of distanced myself here. I'm not following. I'm gonna hang back in this room, like, cause I don't even care.
Where are you going?
I'm going
just straight up.
Hey, I use my powers of perception to tell if Ricky D is at all like bobbing his head to the music. Like, is he into it or is he completely like not feeling the same?
I mean, are you bobbing your head or not? You ask him.
I'm not asking, I'm just looking.
I'm not bobbing my head, but, like, tapping my toe.
All right.
Tapping my toe.
Cool.
Yeah. One, a single toe.
I'm gonna stay on course right now.
But I saw you look at it and I stopped. And I was like, I don't really like anything of this music.
He's
like,
Medder's more into Ricky.
You're the only guys in the room.
Yeah.
Everyone else is in the kitchen drinking, he's just by himself. Damn it.
You're staying in there, sorry.
Yeah, I'm gonna stay.
Okay. I'm right there with Faye.
So, Chad goes behind the bar, and you can hear, so they walk up, and Faye's like,
so, are you going to, like, college or something after high school, or what are you into?
Well, I got some scholarships, you know, from track, and so I plan on pretty much running my way through a free degree.
She's like, that's cool. You know, I was thinking I was just going to take some time off for a while and, you know, maybe travel the world for a bit. You know, just get some of those life experiences you can't get in school.
Oh, that's cool. Where do you want to go?
Oh, I don't know. You know, I was thinking maybe going to like some wood elf place or something, like, because they're so free and peaceful. And like, I was just thinking, like, I really want to live like the wood elves.
I audibly go, ugh.
You know, did you know that in wood elf culture, there's no violence?
I didn't know. I mean, I've never left this town. So I'm just happy I'm fast because
you know in Wood Elf culture,
see the world.
Did you know they have 20 words for just the word bark?
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's amazing. I mean, I'd love to just learn all 20 words for bark sometime.
These yeah, Wood Elves, isn't that funny? Isn't that funny?
I mean, it's just thinking about it. I know nothing about Wood Elves, and look at me in a small town.
Can I hear this at all?
You're in the other room listening to the dwarf step still okay, with the so two dudes.
I don't hear this.
You guys aren't like really joining the thing yet.
Cool. What are wood elves' houses like?
Oh, the wood elves, they love to live in the trees and they don't have any roofs or they don't have money or anything. It's all trade based.
That's crazy. You don't need a big house like this to be happy.
No, you don't. But it is kind of cool. I guess I don't really get to see houses like this very much.
Yeah, neither do I. We'll have to take a look around it sometime later.
Yeah, that's
just
super cool.
Explore a little bit, right?
Yeah, that'd be fun. I love exploring.
Cool. All right. We'll be like wood elves, just like look at their own, see what we see.
All right. So Chad's behind the bar and he's like, oh dang, dude, I can't find the beer. Oh,
the barley wine barrels aren't it. Oh, there might be some in the cellar or the pantry. Maybe I can take a look.
And he goes over to this door here for this roof and he shakes on it. He's like, oh no, it's locked. Dad locked it. Oh, you knew you were going to be partying.
Oh. I go, hey, don't worry about it. I brought my lockpick set.
Oh, really? Oh, perfect.
Let me get a crack at
You're like
that.
Way over here listening to the dwarf steps. You're like way in the other room.
You come running in.
It's my nocturnal hearing. It's a gift my father gave me with his curse, and no big deal.
His curse.
So
nocturnal hearing?
Shut up.
I can hear better when it's dark.
aren't you listening to your music?
Yeah, you've got a fucking phone in one ear.
And you're the one that's good with your hands.
Yeah.
Why don't you concentrate on your music there, huh?
If you failed me, we're gonna
call. Yeah.
Like, alright, where's the door?
Right here.
Okay, I'm gonna walk up to the door. Plus six to my sleight of hand. Here we go.
Oh man, what a way to start.
Crit fail. That's a D roll.
Okay,
right
so
there.
As I'm trying to pick the lock, what happens?
The lock pick breaks and jams inside the door. Huh? And you've jammed the lock inside there.
I go, shit, It's just like way too bright in here, guys. I just like, I can't, like, it's like fucking me up. I'm sorry, guys. I really messed that up.
Nedrum's really good.
There's still gotta be a way to maybe fix
that's
it.
True.
Oh, right. Man, I just want to break the door down. I'm so angry.
No.
These people are coming to my house for a party. Oh, it's gonna be the worst party ever. Everyone's gonna hate me.
I'm not, for any reason other than this, just, but I got tired of kind of Nedrum and his vibing to his own music. So I kind of just wandered in there because I'm like, I want a drink already. I know I just walked in there, but I clearly see that lockpick is broken now.
Mm-hmm.
And I turn around and I just walk out to the front where I'm gonna just hit the pipe. because everything is going badly very quickly here. This
front door?
Yeah, I just go back out the front. You know, hit the pipe out front.
You grab the doorknob and you shake it. It's locked. It won't open.
Okay. Mm. Can I shoulder it? Because I don't give a fuck about
you.
Yeah,
you shoulder
door.
It. You roll a strength check against it.
For saving throw.
Dang.
What did you roll?
19.
19 plus 5, so 24 total. And you break the door. You straight up break the door open.
Sorry, Chad, not really.
So you've broken it open. Cool.
Okay. I just step outside and light my pipe. Literally, right at the door, you know?
So you step outside and you start to feel like, ugh, really sick, and you take a point of damage. You're like, your whole body hurts for some reason.
That sucks. Okay, yeah. I'm going back inside. I'll just smoke in Chad's house.
This party sucks.
So you have to dock a hit point from yourself.
And I walk inside, and I was like, yo, I don't know if anyone cares, but outside hurt me.
So, I go, what?
Letting you know. I don't know, man. I went outside and it hurt me. But I probably because I just really want to smoke, I guess.
So you're smoking right now.
I look at Chad and go, hey Chad. So you're saying all the liquor is past this door, right?
Yeah, dude, it's in the freaking wine cellar, dude.
Okay.
It's in the cellar.
Your dad
or it's in
seems
pantry?
Like he's preloaded. There's a nice house. What if we just break the door down and then you just tell him something wrong happened? Because dude, the party's gonna be ruined if we don't get this alcohol, man. Yeah.
Oh, we shouldn't have signed that blood pact. All right, let's do it.
All right, let's break this shit down.